Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I will show you SR830 lock-in amplifier. So this video is going to useful those are using lock-in amplifier for the first time. So as you can see, this is the front panel of lock-in amplifier. There are lot of switches, lot of functions, but don't worry, I will try to explore all the switches. Okay, so let's see the rear panel of this lock-in amplifier. As you can see, this is the rear panel of this lock-in amplifier, and this is the power cable, and this is for GPIB to interface the instrument with computer, and this is the RS232 DC connector, and this is the preamplifier. Okay, and there are a lot of switches if you want to apply bias or something. Okay, there are many functions, and this is the switches. After plug it the power cable, you have to make it on so that it can be started. Okay, now let's go to the front panel again, and I will show you how it will work. So after just switch on this power and on the rear panel switch, it will takes few seconds to initialize this instrument. Okay, now every light like LED bulb is on, and this there are three panel, so they are showing some random values. Okay, now let's start to understand one switch one by one, and the three panels and these things. So the basic of this instrument we discussed in earlier two videos, namely part one lock-in amplifier and part two lock-in amplifier. Okay, so to understand the basic function of this lock-in amplifier, you need one BNC connector, that's all. Okay, so if you want to explore more and more complicated functions, then you need different instruments, different experiments to understand lot of things. But to understand and to use its first time, so you just need one BNC connector. Okay, so let's see. So as you can see, I connected one BNC cable. This is the sine output. Okay, this is the sine output of this lock-in amplifier. Okay, as you know, inside the lock-in there is itself a sine wave generator, or this in reference input. That means this switch, this BNC cable, you can also put from the outside some synchronized reference input. But here, for the simplest case, I am using this reference sine wave from the instrument itself, and I connected other end of this BNC to the input A. Okay, so if you have two input, then you can connect with A and B, and then you have to take this difference A. Instead, here I am using A, so if you press it, it will come to A minus B, then current with gain 10 to the power 6, then 10 to the power 8. Okay, then again it will go to the A. So but as I have only one input, that's why I am switching the LED in the beside the A option. Okay, and if you want to use float or ground, then you have to change this accordingly this. Okay, so and for AC and DC measurement, you have to just press this and this. Okay, and this is the time constant or sensitivity. So this, there is main thing is the time constant that we will discuss in detail, and this is the sensitivity, so that also an important factor. And in this first channel or first display, as you can see, there are XR, X noise, aux in one, aux in two. So if you press this display, then it will change accordingly. So you can also, as there are two display X, this Y, and you can also change it from R, then this is theta, or whatever option you need, that also, that is you can see. So you maybe you want X Y, maybe you need X theta, maybe you need R Y, maybe you need R theta or X Y, that depends on you. And this is the display, and this is the, by using this you can change the value of this display. Okay, now this frequency phase, if I click phase option, it will show phase difference is 0, and if I click frequency, it will show 1 kilohertz, and you can change whatever it will show in the display, that you can change using this knob. Okay, now it is changing like this. Okay, and if you want to change the amplitude, now it's 0.102 voltage. So if you want to make it 0.1 volt, then you have to decrease it accordingly, this knob. And this is for the harmonic, if you want to work in first harmonic, second harmonic, like this. Okay, and this 90 degree is for phase difference increase plus 90, and this minus 90 is for decreasing minus 90. Okay, and if you are using source internal, then you have to press internal, otherwise you have to. Now this option is red because I am not connecting any output reference in the lock-in, so I am using here internal lock-in lock-in source, sine source, that's why this LED should be on. Okay, and this, if you want to change in auto mode like phase, gain, or reserve, then you have to press it like this, three options. Okay, now as you can see, this frequency is 1 kilohertz and this amplitude is 0.1 volt. So in the sensitivity options, now this is the 500 millivolt. Okay, that means my input is 0.1 volt. That means it's okay. So I will change this sensitivity. Let's see how it will look like. So if I decrease, this is the decrease switch. If I decrease, then as you can see, this bar will display the how much it can go. So if it is going to till this, that means this is the maximum capacity, okay, in this sensitivity option. So now it's 200 millivolt. Okay, it is fine for this input option. Now let's change it more. So now it is 100. Okay, so 0.1 volt is input is 0.1 volt, that means it's 100 millivolt. So if you are using this 100 millivolt sensitive option, this is not good because it is using this maximum capacity. So sometimes it's crossing the 100 millivolt. Okay, so it's better option to choose first increase this option. So in this amplitude case, 200 millivolt is the best option to choose the sensitivity. So now we understand how sensitivity option will work. So if you want, if your amplitude is more, then you have to increase the sensitivity. Here maximum sensitivity is the 1 volt. So now this is the 500 millivolt. Okay, and this is the 1 volt. So maximum it can go to the 1 volt, and if you press it, it will not go. Okay, so maximum option is the 1 volt. And if it is now showing overload because it is showing 10 millivolt, because my sensitivity option is the maximum 10 millivolt, but if I do 20, so maximum is the minimum I have to give to the 200 millivolt, so that it can display properly 100 millivolt input or 100 millivolt output from the X channel. Okay. And one more thing, now it is showing 100 millivolt, and this Y, this should be so 0 because here I am seeing in the X and Y mode. So X channel is showing 100 millivolt and Y channel should show 0. And if I press this again plus 90, this switch, then it should show reverse. That means it will trying to be 0 in the X channel, and Y channel should be so the negative of minus of this input voltage. That means the minus of 100 millivolt. Now let's go to the initial position. So I will go to the again here. Okay, now it came to the initial position. So it was showing earlier like that means X input is showing near 100 millivolt and Y input is showing near 0 millivolt, although there is some error is there, that is 3 point something millivolt. Okay, now we will understand the time constant. This is the most important part in the lock-in amplifier. So now time constant is the 330 millisecond. Okay, now let's make it lowest, or maybe 300 microsecond. Okay, now it is 300 microsecond, and as you can see, this is fluctuating. This is not fixed. So what does that mean? So that means in the low pass filter, this output signal cannot pass properly. So here I will see the frequency, which frequency we are working. So this is the 101 kilohertz. Okay, so if you calculate the corresponding time constant for the 1 kilohertz frequency, so that will pass easily, no problem. But if you want to but the two way frequency, that means 2 kilohertz frequency, so that component is also is creating the problem. So that's why you have to increase the time constant. So if I increase time constant here, so as you can see, now it is 1 millisecond. So it's stable compared to the earlier. So if I increase the time constant more, then now it is 3 millisecond. So it's stable. So if you increase more time constant, then it is now 30 millisecond time constant. Okay, as you can see, there is 30 millisecond. So now this value is quite stable. Okay, so if you want to use if you want to increase time constant more, then you can see there is no much changes in the earlier time constant and the new time constant. Okay, so accordingly you have to choose the proper time constant to display less noisy result in the lock-in amplifier. Okay, and in the time constant there is one more thing, that is the slope per oct. So if you choose 6 dB, that means there is only one pole, and if you choose 12 dB, that means there are two pole, 18 dB there are three pole, and 24 dB there are four poles. So accordingly it will, so for better performance of this of your experiment, and it should be high, so that pole, if it is 24 dB, that means it's 24 by 6, that means four pole this circuit is there, so that it will be easier to be less noisy, so your output will be less noisy. Okay, so this will go to the this is completed the discussion of time constant and sensitivity for the those who are using this first time of this instrument, lock-in amplifier. There are many things to be done in this lock-in amplifier, and if you want to fetch the output from channel 1, that means this one, and this one that is from channel 2, then you can also use another BNC cable and to do some experiments. Okay, and this is the interface option. If you want to connect, as I showed earlier, in the rear panel there is a GPIB port, and in that GPIB port, if you want to use GPIB connection from using the GPIB port to the instrument and computer, then you can use, and accordingly you can set the GPIB address, etc. Okay, so now this completed our discussion as of now. So if you have any doubts, you can write in the comment section. Thank you for watching.